In this video, we are going to take a look at how to use TikTok to sell more of your low content books like coloring books and journals. Welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to join me here. If you haven't already subscribed, please consider doing so because I would really love to see you back here next week. Personally, I think the hardest part about writing or creating and publishing any kind of book is actually selling it. I feel like the work really does begin when you hit publish and your book is available for sale. And there's a bit of a misconception out there that all you need to do is publish a book on Amazon, and because they do have such a large built-in customer base, that your book is just going to take off and become a bestseller while you put your feet up on some tropical beach somewhere. And maybe this is true for about 1% of books, probably even less than 1% of books published, but for the other 99% of us out there, we do have to put in some work to help drive sales, especially those initial sales when a book is newly published. Some people do this by building up an email list and getting their subscribers to help by buying the book when it becomes available. Or some people do a big marketing push using Amazon ads or even something like Facebook ads. And then lastly, others use their social media accounts to build up a following of people who are interested in those kind of books that they publish and promote their books through their social media accounts. And that's social media accounts like Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok. And TikTok is what we are going to focus on today because it really has become such a great place to promote books, probably one of the best places in terms of free promotion to be able to promote your books. I did a couple of videos a while ago now talking about using TikTok to sell more low content books, and then shared another video more recently about using TikTok, or maybe we can call it BookTok, and that BookTok trend to promote high content books. So this video, we are going to look at TikTok to sell more low content books for those of you watching who are more interested in publishing low content books like coloring books and journals and are just struggling to make sales, or you're struggling to come up with some sort of marketing plan. I have a few different accounts on TikTok and a few different videos on TikTok that I do want to share with you today. So let's just get straight into it and let's head on over to TikTok. First of all, if you are just doing research to see what kinds of videos you could even make about your book, basically just get onto TikTok and search for the kind of books that you publish or that you would like to publish. And if you are just doing research, I'd recommend not signing into your own TikTok account if you've got one. Just look on TikTok without logging in so that you don't mess up your search history and affect the algorithm in your actual account. So whatever kind of book you make, just search for it. In this example, I've just done a search for coloring book. So you could search for coloring or coloring book. And let's just go through what kind of videos have come up. We can search through the top videos, or we can search through the top accounts that are related to coloring books. So whichever you prefer to go through is up to you. I just like to look at what the most currently trending videos are, and you will see that they're not all the most recently uploaded videos either. Videos that were uploaded earlier this year or last year or even a couple of years ago can still be trending. As we can see here, the top three videos that have popped up in this particular search were all uploaded in 2022, and we'll just click on one and see what they're all about. So this is looks like a daily challenge or something that this person's doing. Looks like they're focusing on doing some form of art every single day. So day 88 of 365. What a great way to get people invested in what you're doing and perhaps even do something similar themselves. And this video is just a video of this particular person coloring in a coloring page. And down here in the comments, they have tagged who it was that created those coloring pages and that coloring book. So if anybody else wants to go buy it, they can. They know where to get it. And that particular video at the moment has almost 300,000 views. Now, this one is just showing a new coloring book that this person got. If you have seen any of my previous videos where I do deep dives into particular niches, I do seem to do quite a lot of videos around coloring books. You would have seen this one before. I have featured it in videos before, and you would have seen it come up in search results when I've just done searches on Amazon. It is a very good selling book on Amazon. And all they've done is they're just showing the coloring book that they bought and asking people to comment a number. So she's numbered the pages. She's going to pick one based on the comments of which page to color in. And this is a great way to create that engagement. Getting people to comment on her videos is getting people interacting with this video. And we can see here in the comments, she has commented what this book is and where she got it from. She got it from Amazon, and she's generated 233 comments on her video by doing this. And again, that video is close to 300,000 views as well. Let's have a look at this one. It has 15.2 million views, and she's just replying to somebody's comment where they commented that for some reason they were unfollowing her. And the video is basically just her coloring in a little mushroom on a coloring page. So it is such a simple video that I feel like nobody can say, I can't create a TikTok account and create videos like this, or a video like this wouldn't get me that many views, because it just happens. You don't have to create these elaborate, time-intensive, professional looking videos. Something as simple as this has generated 15 million views on TikTok. Now, if this was your coloring book, or if this person was selling this coloring book, all they would have to do is pop that into the comments. This comment section has over 3,500 comments. So you can just imagine the amount of people who might end up clicking on that link or going and finding the coloring book and buying it for themselves out of those 15 million views. We've got this one here, which is just showing coloring book. She's going to color in a page with some crayons. And her comment on the video is basically that the coloring book link is in the bio. So whether this is her coloring book that she's promoting, I'm assuming it is. All she's done is just set up her camera or her phone or whatever she's using above her page, and she's just filming herself coloring it in. And this particular video has 3 million views. And we'll look at just one more video. We've got this one here. It's got 1.7 million views, and it's talking about some sort of mistake that she's made with her book. Now, this is a good tactic too, because it's going to get people to keep watching, because people want to find the mistake and they're going to keep watching the video until they find it. And so that's going to generate, hopefully, people watching the video multiple times, which is telling TikTok that people love this video so much that they're continuing to watch it over and over again, when in fact, they're just trying to find this mistake that she's apparently made in this particular book. And I don't think that calling out when you've made a mistake on something is going to be bad, and it's not going to affect your sales or anything like that. And you can even see here in the comments, people are saying, I didn't even notice it. Took me so long to find it. Still love the page. Never noticed it until now. Still love the book. Nevertheless, this was one of my favorite pages and I never noticed it. I instantly saw it, but it's still cute. And so you can see that it isn't really affecting people's opinion of this page or this coloring book, that there is some sort of mistake in there. So there's a whole range of different tactics that you can use. And the idea is to basically get people to stay on your videos as long as you can possibly get them to stay there and to interact somehow, whether that's through a like, a comment, or a save or a share or something like that with your video. If you haven't started your account yet, or maybe you have started a TikTok account, but you haven't posted much, or what you have posted hasn't really generated many views, don't let that deter you. Especially when you do look at some of these videos that have hundreds of thousands, even millions of views. In the last video that I shared not too long ago about using TikTok to sell books, I talked a little bit about the TikTok algorithm and how it works. And the great thing about TikTok is that it doesn't matter about the size of your follower account or even how your previous videos have performed. The TikTok algorithm does not take any of that into consideration when you post a new video. All it does is look at that most recent or that most current video that you have posted and how TikTok users are interacting with it. If people are loving it, if they're interacting with it, so if they're liking, sharing, commenting, or anything like that on your videos, then that video is going to get shown to more and more people. Even if you have no followers, and even if your previous videos have not done that well. And this is why you do go onto TikTok and see accounts that either don't have many followers or their previous videos have hardly any views, and then they all of a sudden have a video with millions and millions of views. That one particular video just happened to resonate with TikTok users and take off. So let's take a look at some accounts that are specific to low content books. Okay, I do want to have a quick look at this particular account and see what it is that she's doing. So she makes stationery and art for Black girls, coloring book, calendars, and more, and she's got over 400,000 followers. She has a link to her own website, and so she's just showing her products, her books. So this video is just asking which page is your favorite. Again, that's getting people to interact by hopefully commenting which page is their favorite. This one's showing that her coloring book is back in stock. People love love unboxing videos, which of course isn't something that we would be doing as publishers on KDP, but you could perhaps order a bunch of your books from KDP and do a similar kind of unboxing. And so she's obviously very artistic and very good at coloring in. She doesn't just color in her book like the majority of us would probably color in our books. She has a lot of detail. It's very artistic the way she colors her books. But again, don't let that deter you if you're not really artistic or creative, if you feel like you can't really color in that great, if coloring books is what you do, because you'll see that not every coloring book video is someone who can color in spectacularly well. So let's look at the next account I want to share. This one's called Satisfying Page, 372,000 followers and coloring books that she somehow sells through Instagram by the looks of it. This one I thought was interesting. So this person has a coloring book that is just patterned pages that you can color in. And what this person is also doing is getting people to interact with the video. So replying to people's comments or getting people to comment to be able to do something. So perhaps tell me what color you want me to color next. And she'll pick a comment and she'll color in the color that that person has asked for or something like that. And you can see that all these videos are basically the same. There's nothing really different about them. It's all just her coloring in the same page of the same coloring book. So perhaps each day she's coloring in one puzzle piece from her book based on the comments and people commenting what color they want her to do next. I mean, a very simple idea that's showing off the coloring book. It's getting people to interact with her account and then hopefully getting people to head on over to her books and buy them for themselves. I just thought that account was really interesting, how the videos are just basically all the same, really simple, really engaging for the people who are into what colors she's going to do next. So this account was the coloring book up here, the Secret Worlds coloring book, because this is one that is sold through Amazon KDP. The amount of followers isn't massive compared to the last couple of accounts we've looked at, 39,000 followers. And while her account isn't specific to coloring books, it looks like there's a lot of art related things on her account. And so this is the video here that we looked at with the Secret Worlds coloring book from Amazon. And you can see all the videos around that didn't generate a massive amount of views. And that particular one just took off and it got a heap of views, which probably really helped that person sell a lot of books on Amazon. And then the next video she did is where she's chosen somebody's comment and she's now going to color that page in. So you might be seeing a similar theme here of where people are getting people interacting, getting them to comment, getting them involved in what they're doing, which is what that TikTok algorithm is looking for. The next account I'm looking at is Bobby Goods and nearly a million followers. So quite a large account and has a lot of likes on her videos. This person does create their own coloring books and promotes them through her own website. And she just creates videos basically featuring her images from her coloring books or pages from her coloring books. And if we look through her videos, it really seems like all the videos that show her coloring are the ones that gets the most amount of views. So we've got a 1.1 million view video, which is announcing that her books are back in stock so people can buy them. I mean, imagine getting 1 million views, which is a video telling people that your book is in stock. The next one that is quite large in terms of views is 1.8 million views, and that's just her coloring in a page from her book. 3.8 million views is her printing a page and coloring it. 2.7 million views is her taking a page and coloring it in. 1.5 million views, her taking a page and coloring it in. You get the idea. And I hope as well what you can see with this is that you don't have to be on camera. If you don't want your face on camera, if you don't want your voice on camera, all you have to do is just set up your phone or your camera showing your page and your hands, I guess, coloring in, what kind of colors you're choosing or even what kind of markers or what kind of pens or pencils you're using to color in. And you can see by this account that her coloring in isn't anything out of this world like that previous account we looked at where her coloring was very, very creative. This kind of coloring is quite simple and it's the kind of coloring that a lot of people can do. So you don't have to be some artist to create these kind of videos and have them do well. Now, the next account I wanted to show you was quite interesting because it might give you some ideas if you are someone who creates books that are more like puzzle books or activity books, because I also do talk a lot about puzzle books on my channel. I think they're a great low content or medium content book to create and publish. And this one was interesting. interesting. She does videos about crosswords and puzzles. And there might be a way that you could possibly create some kind of videos similar to this in order to promote a puzzle book. We can see she's got a great amount of followers, 165,000. She's got a lot of likes on her videos and they do pretty well. And it looks like she just completes puzzles and helps other people complete puzzles. Because you can see here, people are asking, can you help with one from the Washington Post? And so it just looks like people ask her for help with puzzles. In this video, she's asking for help with this particular puzzle. So I find this account really interesting and that people are into it. You can see her videos getting some great amount of views on them. And I think this is a really good account to maybe study. And if you do publish puzzle books, how can you do something similar to this using the puzzles out of your own book and then be able to promote that book through this account? So I just thought this one was such a good example of something totally different from what we usually see on TikTok, which is usually the more creative and artistic stuff like coloring books. And to find this account that is doing really well with something like puzzles and crosswords, I thought was a really great example. So if you do create puzzle books, go check out this account and see if you can create something similar to be able to promote your puzzles and your puzzle books through a TikTok account. So hopefully this video has given you some ideas about how you can go about using TikTok to sell more books like coloring books. And of course, this isn't limited to just coloring books. Low content books are comprised of a lot of different books in a lot of different niches, but the principles are basically the same. If you're looking for a free way to market your books, TikTok is still currently the best place to do that. If you do publish a type of book, or perhaps you publish in a niche that we haven't looked at in this video, just hop onto TikTok and do some research on the kind of books that you are publishing and see if anybody else is creating any kind of videos about that particular topic or niche and what kind of videos they are creating. And hopefully this will give you some ideas that you can try out yourself, or you can even look at similar kind of books or other low content books and try to create similar videos to that for your own books and see if any of it works. It's all just about trial and error. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.